Hey, turn it up, turn it up, turn it up. Man, this guy, Darius Rucker, man. This old cowboy is. Crank it up.
Gonna call my girl and say, let's get our friends and hit the lake.
Hey, hey. Oh, nice boat.
A little buzz, a little toasted.
Hell yeah! Sing it, man! Sing it, yo, cowboy, you! Oh yeah, grab me a beer! Hey, where's my beer? Hey! Where's my beer at? Oh yeah, I drank it all! Sing it, boy! Yo, cowboy, you! I'm just old cowboy myself there, Darius! Man, you can sing country western, man! Just like Charlie Pride and Garth Brooks, you're the man. Oh, look, whose breakup is that? Oh, hey, deep, 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 red truck. Oh, yeah, that's what, that's living. He, that boy knows how to live.
South Carolina.
Yeah, woo! Yeah, beer, here comes the beer. Or tequila, mezcal. Check my taters. I'm gonna show you a secret how to cook anything. Uh-oh. Shit. Fire in the hole. Fire in the hole. Don't burn yourself. Now that's not a steak. That's... What is that? Oh my God. Okay. See, that's his coffee grounds, but that's better than this one. There's those taters. Again, add those to the last night sausage gumbo right here. Right there. Make sure it's not hot.
Four babies having a baby. 16 and pregnant is back. I'm 100%. Can these families push through? She's terrible.
Wait a minute.
Together. We'll help you bring this baby into the world, right? 16 and pregnant returns Tuesday, March 16th on MTV.
Papa John's is known for its crispy, fresh crust full of warm...
Okay, where do we go?
And now they're known for stuffing those...
Okay.
Jeez.
Now, that method right there... Usually I have an inch and a half thick ribeye right here, medium heat, and then put some beer in there, and something else, just salt and pepper, and something else I've forgotten, and then put that bigger one on top, and that beer turns to steam, and my God, it's the juiciest ribeye I've ever had. That's the way to do it. Well, that's how I'm doing it. So you can, that's my secret. Now what?
Trusted
what? I can't hear you. What? I can't hear you.
Spicy chicken.
What? 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 Damn it. Man, I'm sure I'm... Hey, there's my saddle. Bought that at pawn shop. Hell yeah, look at that saddle. Now, on March the 2nd, Texas Independence Day, I'm going to get me a horse. I guess, anyway... Anyway, I always wanted a horse. Anyway, I call them horsies. But I need the horse and some rescue donkeys. I'm going to breed my own goddamn pack mules. Well, I'm going to buy that ranch up in Montana around Missoula. And I need at least 7 pack mules. Good pack mules, because 2 of them pack mules, they're going to be carrying pony kegs of beer and tequila. And mezcal, and oh, I love a good Merlot from Argentina or Chile. There's my banjo. Yep, there's my blood. I sacrificed my blood to bring y'all music last night. It does. There's the pickups. I don't know. There's my dobro. What is it, a national? Well, that's upside down. National, the ribs, the stamp says 28 years old. There's the resonator. It too plugs in. There's, see that piece of copper? That's the pickup. It sounds pretty good. And I was using it as a drum last night. It's also on the, somewhere, you'll see it. had a friend over. He's also Cherokee. Anyway, we had fun. There's a piano. What is this? What is this? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. What's that say? Austin Hash House Harriers. Them. That's that crazy group. Austin Hash House Harriers, a drinking club with a running problem. Them goddamn people that go out and set that trap, they do it on purpose. They try to cause you pain. I wonder why I fit in with them guys. Oh, yeah, I know how to run. But I'd also, I've been drinking longer than I've been running, I guess. So, yes, I like to drink. I'm German. I'm from Texas. And, yes, a real Texan will drink a beer for breakfast. Thank you. Not this one. That was my last beer last night. So, anyway, those guys, they're all ex-military intelligence. Yeah, either gather the intel or analyze it or do both. Or anyway, I kind of fit in because I was kind of intel officer for Brown and Root. Rooty, fruity, fresh, and tooty. 1977-78, South Texas Nuclear Project. Field Engineer, Reactor Containment Building, Unit 1. Boy, you ever seen number 18 rebar? Butt welded with thermite that burns at 5,400 degrees? Well, number 18, well, here it is. A number 8 rebar is 1 inch in diameter. A number 16 rebar would be 2 inches. So a number 18 would be 2 1/4 inch in diameter. And when they said fire in the hall, you better make sure you're not beneath it, because sometimes that cotton wadding of that CAD welding, it blows out, and here comes an avalanche of burning pain if you're underneath it. It will kill you. It, and the only people that could get fit inside that 5 foot thick rebar mess was the boat people from Vietnam. They're good people. They were small enough that they could crawl through that shit, man. You couldn't even see through it. And they're in there setting up the next CAD weld. Holy moly, I saw some weird stuff. God, what was it? 4,500 of us worker bees, and it was a two-way dirt road, two-lane coming in and out of the parking lot. And then if you turn right going away, you go to Houston. If you turn left, you go down to Corpus. South Texas Nuclear Project, Bay City was right in between them. So, everybody didn't want, well, the idiots would get out and wait in traffic and get all antsy. Well, yeah, the welders, they would have the coldest beer in their igloo. And us field engineers, we would have beer and Colombian gold to smoke to calm our nerves. Yeah. Well, I'm not going to say anything else, but there's a bunch of chemists, master chemists for like DuPont and Union Carbide. Well, they had to make some side money. God, the purest, the most beautiful crystal methadrine I've ever had was came in out at that coastal bend. God, they call it Cancer Alley. And then the only way you can cope with risk of getting cancer is to self-medicate yourself. Ah! Anyway, I'm telling secrets. They taught me precision layout. Then they taught me precision demolition. I didn't say that. Yeah, you saw the beer that I was drinking last night. So, man, maybe, I don't know. I don't know nothing about nothing no more. End of story.